Okay, so in this video, we'll be talking about electrical plant. Okay, so electrical plant. So the definition of electrical plant is that it is a very detailed type of electrical print typically used in construction to show the location and the types of electrical devices for a construction project. So the electrical plan will contain the following: the power layout, the lighting layout, the symbols, the feeder or riser diagram, the load computation, the schedule of loads, the notes and specification, the location or site plan, and the nameplate. Okay, so we have here the parts of an electrical plan or the contents of it. So first we will have the floor plan. So it is an overview of the completed house. So you see the parallel lines that is scaled or that scaled at whatever width the walls are required to be. Dimensions are usually drawn between the walls to specify room sizes and the wall lengths. Floor plans will include notes to specify finishes, construction methods, or symbols for electrical items. So this is an example of a floor plan. So as you can see, it will contain the parts of the house, no? The bedroom, the living room, the toilet and bathroom, the canopy, the kitchen, and the patio. Also, you can see here the walls, no? The walls. So the dimension of the walls and the shape of the walls. We now go to the power layout. So the power layout contains the number of outlets, the number of circuits, and its location. So this is an example of a power layout. So these are the symbols for an outlet, no? So as you can see, we have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We have 13 outlets. They are divided into 3 circuits, no? Because we have here the symbol for the home run, and each home run is equivalent to 1 circuit, and each circuit in the plan will be equivalent to 1 circuit breaker. Okay, and this is the symbol or the location of the panel board. Okay, you have the lighting layout, contains the number of lights, number of circuit home runs, and its location. So we have here the example of a lighting layout. So as you can see, these are the symbol for the lights, no? This also the lighting layout, it will contain also the switch, no? And the location of the switch. So we have here the switch which will be put in this side of the wall. Okay, then we have also the number of home runs. So we have 2. So we have 2 circuits, and we have also 2 circuit breakers. Then we have electrical symbols. So these are small drawings of pictograms used to represent various electrical devices in a diagram or plan of an electric circuit. So the symbols are used in sketching schematic diagrams and electrical plan for numerous types of electrical works. Practically, any electrical fixture found in the house or in a building or in a plan has a symbol that coincides to the said fixture on an electrical wiring diagram. Okay, so we have here the common electrical symbols which we are going to use if we have our power and lighting layout. So we have here the wall, no? These are the symbols for the wall, meaning our devices will be mounted on the wall or will be put on the wall or installed on the wall. We have also the ceiling, no? Meaning this will be the symbol if our devices will be installed in the ceiling. So the junction box, the lamp holders. So these are the outlets. So duplex convenient outlet, meaning this symbol is for a 2-gang outlet. Then you have the single or the triplex. So if, for example, when the symbol of the outlet, we put here 1. So meaning that convenience outlet is a single gang. If you put that 1, 3, so that outlet has 3, no? 3-gang. Then you have the range outlet, no? As you can see, it has 3 lines here. Then we have the outlet with switch, no? The special purpose outlet for heavy appliances or air cons. We have the floor outlet, which should be installed in the floor. Then we have the switches. So the switches are mounted on the wall. So these are the symbols for the switches. So we have the single pole, the double pole, 3-way. 4-way, so on and so forth. And these are the symbols for lighting switch or the lighting panel and the power panel. Then we have also the lights, no? We have the ceiling light, no? The common bulb that we are going to use, LED or incandescent or CFL. We have this one symbol for fluorescent lamp, then the service meter or the kilowatt hour meter, then the service entrance, then the buzzer, the speaker, no? If our house has an intercom, no? We have, so the speaker, the push button or the doorbell, no? The doorbell button, then we have here the bell, no? And then the common electrical symbol used in electrical diagrams. So if you are going to make an electrical diagram, these are the symbols that we are going to use. Okay, so we have a symbol for a single brick switch or a single pole switch. Then we have also here the float switch. So the type, these are for the switches. So these are for the indicators. We have the pilot light and the, this one will be the pilot light to test. No, we have the fuse, you know, the overload relays, the wirings. No, so if it is just closing, that is not connected, jumper not connected, and if it has a dot, no, meaning that those wires are connected or they are spliced together. Then the power cable for a thicker line, the control cable for a thinner line, and you have also the home run, which is aligned with arrows. Then the dash will be underground or embedded on the ground, and you have the concealed in floor. Then we have here the symbol for a piping, which contains, indicates how many conductors are present. So this this will be the indication of the conductor. So if we have 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, so this pipe will contain 4 conductors. Okay, then we have here the another for the protection, no? The overcurrent protection. So this is for a 3-pole breaker with a magnetic overloads. This is for the single throw, no? The single throw 3-pole fuse switch or the main safety switch. Then we have the toe-pole single throw. Then we have the toe-pole single throw breaker, and this is for a single pole. This is for a single pole switch and a single pole breaker. Then you have the current transformer, the potential transformer, solenoid, no? Capacitor, the blowout, the thermal overload heaters, the normally close contact, no? If we have here drawn like this, then we don't put this one, that will become a normally open contact. Then coil, the ground, and the battery. Then the feeder or riser diagram and panel board details. So it is a simplified conventional pictorial representation of the feeder line. It shows the sizes of wires, conduits, type of conductor, insulation, and as well as the ampacity of wires and the circuit protection and its designated circuit number. Okay, so this is the example of a wall-line diagram and a panel board detail. So this is a wall-line diagram. This is the service entrance. So the supply voltage is 230 volts AC, single phase, 60 hertz. We have here the symbol for the meter. This is the panel board, and these are the circuit home runs. So for this wall-line diagram, it will indicate how many home runs. So we have 2, no? Then this is the panel board details. So it will contain here the size of wire and the conduit. Then we have also the meter here, the size of wire, and the what is inside the panel board. So our main is 40, and our circuit number 1 is 15 amperes, circuit number 2 is 20 amperes, circuit number 3 is 20 amperes, and circuit number 4 is 20 amperes. And this is now our grounding, no? Grounding. So our grounding is 8.0 square mm bare copper wire. Okay? Then we have the nameplate, no? So the nameplate contains the data of the design engineers, project owner, location, and etc. So it contains the name of the project, the location of the project, the name of the owner of the project, the name and the signature of the professional electrical engineer, the sheet number, then the name and the signature of the civil engineer, the name and signature of the drafter or the architect, and the sheet contained. No? Sheet contained. Then we have the load schedule. So the load schedule is a table containing the description of the circuits and the load in watts, computed current, rated voltage, circuit protection, size of conduit, and size of conductor. So this is an example of load schedule. So for this one, this is panel PP, no, or power panel. The enclosure is NEMA 1, no, with neutral and grounding provisions. So the first circuit, no, is a the load will be 20 watts CFL, which is 15 pieces. Then we have a 10 single pole switch and 1-3 gang. So we have the voltage, 230 volts, 300 volts, 300 volt ampere, 300 watts is the load, no, or the wattage. Then the current is 1.3 amperes. Then the circuit protection is 15 amperes. The conductor is 2.0 square mm, 2, no, 2 wire. Then the conduit is 20 mm diameter UPVC pipe. So this is how we are going to read or interpret the load schedule. Below is the computation for the feeder and each protection. So the feeder conductor, as indicated, this one is 13.82 and the main is 14 amperes. So this is derived or this is computed from this one here. Okay? Then we have the location and the site plan. So the site plan are drawn to show the location of the project. It is an overhead view of the construction site as it sits in reference to the boundaries of the land. Site plan should outline the utility services, setback requirements, location of the driveways and walkways, and sometimes even topographical data that specify the slope of the terrain. So for an electrical plan, the location plan is included so that we will know how far is the location or the site from the nearest electrical utility post in which we are going to get the supply voltage, because the distance will be the basis for us to know how long will be our service entrance or service drop wire. So what is the length of our service drop or service entrance conductor will depend on the distance of the site from the nearest electrical post. So this is an example of a location or a site plan. So in the site plan, it will indicate the bearing, the name of the streets, and also the location of the site. No? Okay. So that will be all for this discussion for an electrical plan. So I hope you understand something in this video. And as always, enjoy learning.